नमस्ते। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर माय एक्सपीरियंस ऑन द डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स ऑफ द अपॉर्चुनिटीज दैट एग्जिस्ट इन टू आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड मशीन लर्निंग प्रोजेक्ट्स। माय नेम इज मदन एंड आई एम हेल्पिंग द प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजर्स टू ट्रांजिशन देयर करियर इन टू आरपी एंड एआई स्पेस। ऑफन आई गेट अ क्वेश्चन, हाउ टू गेट स्टार्टेड इन टू आरपीए, एआई एंड एमएल, एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट इंडस्ट्री यूज केसेस। And I say it's a very wide question. Let's first understand the different patterns, and those patterns can be applied into any use cases across the industries. Let's get started and try to learn what are those patterns. So number one is hyper-personalization. So hyper-personalization is the machine ability to develop a unique profile for the user. So the objective of hyper-personalization is to develop the unique profile of individual rather than generalizing and creating a classification of the users. And this is all happens through the machine learning and the underlying data, and let this profile learn and adapt eventually with the hyper-correction of the data. So what does this mean? So think about a moment about product recommendation, news recommendation, the email recommendation, or maybe any kind of recommendation today that is happening. So this use case is predominantly used into advertisement, marketing, and the sales in order to create a personalization effect to the users. Number two is autonomous. So the objective of autonomous is to accomplish or achieve any goal or task with minimal or no human intervention from the human. That's what the autonomous is. And classical example is autonomous car, drones, the automated drones that Amazon is today using to deliver the goods. So these are the examples, but it's not limited to the hardware industry or maybe the software. So if you go to hardware today, industry 4.0, it's leveraging the connected factory or the connected industry to get it into the autonomous factory. But if you go toward the software side of the world, primarily into the processes, so front office, back office, and as well as the middle office, they are heavily adopting and driving the autonomous processes by leveraging RPA and AI. Number three is predictive analytics and the decision making. So what does this mean? And let me tell you, predictive analytics is one of the exciting subject of machine learning and artificial intelligence that is helping the business leaders to take an informed decision by leveraging and forecasting or predicting the future from the past data. What does this mean? So let's talk about some of the use cases. For example, employee churn analysis, customer churn analysis, forecasting, budget forecasting, demand forecasting, demand planning, inventory forecasting, or anything. I mean, today, in fact, industry 4.0 or manufacturing are using predictive maintenance. It's nothing about predicting the future and preventing all the things that is happening in industry in order to optimize the operation. And this exists across the horizontal industry. Yeah. Number four is anomaly detection and pattern recognition. So what does this mean? Anomaly detection and pattern recognition is one of the very interesting subject of machine learning that help us to identify from unstructured data the patterns, the different anomaly, and establish a relationship between all this data to find the outliers. And essentially, this helps us take a decision, really this specific data point fit into this overall context or not, and where is the outliers. And great example is the fraud detection, or maybe the risk analysis, or maybe finding the patterns, the performance, or maybe the overall workload of the servers into the infrastructure side of the wall. So this is called anomaly detection and the pattern recognition. Let's take this journey to the next level. And the fourth is recognition. So recognition is all about identifying the objects from the different source of unstructured data. It may be the text, it may be the huge set of images, it may be the videos, or it may be voice, or it may be text, anything. So for example, what I'm talking about, identifying a specific set of objects or images from the huge data, finding a specific pattern into the video, finding a specific set of voice or somebody's voice into the overall audio, or maybe identifying a specific invoice pattern into the bills or huge set of documents. So OCR is one of the most prominent use case into this category. And whenever you see video analytics or maybe the text analytics, this comes into this recognition. So let's take my friend this journey to the next level. And the number sixth is the AI conversational bot. So AI conversational bot, and we already know, right? We are the consumer of Alexa, the Siri, Cortana, and we are surrounded by all these use cases. I do not need to explain to you, but the objective here, the objective of this AI conversational, the way we used to have a conversation with our beloved one, or we used to have a conversation with a human, in similar fashion, a machine should also have a conversation with the human in text, in voice, or maybe in a video format. And what I talked about, the Cortana, Alexa, or Siri, now it started entering into the business context. The organizations started adopting and implementing, and it's becoming the exciting and the prominent use cases into the industry. I am really super excited about AI conversational bot. All right, so taking this journey to the next level, the seventh one, the pattern is the goal-driven systems. So goal-driven systems, I'll not touch upon much today, but essentially it's the ability of machine to learn from the hit and trial. And especially when you go to the stock market, when you go to the very complex manufacturing segment, or maybe go alpha into the weather, this kind of systems are used. So I'll talk sometime later, but these are the seven overall patterns that exist wherever you go into artificial intelligence and machine learning. And quickly, I'm repeating for you once again to just recap. Number one is hyper-personalization. Number two is autonomous systems. Number three is predictive analytics and decision support systems. Number four is anomaly detection and pattern recognition. Number fifth is AI conversational bot. Number six is recognition system. And last but not the least is the goal-driven system. These are the total seven patterns that exist across everywhere. But here is the most prominent question I got from the people. Can I integrate multiple patterns into the single project? And what is my answer? Can you guess? I say, look, technology is all driven by the business need. Technology, it's all driven by the demand. So in case we come across the multiple patterns that is going to solve a very exciting problem statement, why not? We can integrate. And this is the need of the demand, right? A project can be integrated of multiple patterns, but these patterns are important for us, for you, in order to identify the use case and figure it out, what are the patterns, how can you integrate together. So this is all from today. By the way, my name is Madan, and I'm helping the project managers to transition their career into RP and AI space without having any coding experience. In case you like and you feel something very important I missed out, or something that is in you, please don't forget to comment. Thank you very much, and hope to see you again. Thank you.